Hey guys, Welsknight here, and welcome back to another episode of Stardew Valley. And we are here today doing all sorts of amazing things. I wanted to apologize right off the bat for the audio in the last two episodes. I got a new microphone. I got an Audio Technica, an AT3060, and it's running through a Mackie Onyx Blackjack preamp, essentially. And I had my gain turned up a little bit too high, kind of experimenting with the new stuff, and I got clipping. And for any of you who've ever edited audio, once you've got clipping, there's really nothing you can do to get rid of it. So very, very sorry about that, but it should be fixed now, and it should be fixed going forward. I learned my lesson, and I think I've finally got my settings for the new microphone tweaked the way I want them to. So today, what I'd like to do is, once we get all the chores done and all that kind of stuff, I'd like to maybe go a little bit deeper into the mines. Now, I should probably mention, there was one episode of Stardew Valley that I decided not to release. We didn't really accomplish anything. We just went into the mines, went down 5 levels, but that one had the same problem with the audio, so I decided to just re-record it, and here we are now in, I think this is actually 10 episodes. So we're here in spring, and we have all sorts of good stuff around. We can forage for berries. I don't think I've actually shown that off yet. Maybe I have. I don't know. But we're going to gather up those. They're a great source, an absolutely great source of energy for when you head into the mines, because they really don't sell for anything. I think they only sell for like 10 gold or something really low like that. But on the flip side, you can get an absolute ton of them, and it adds up. I mean, you can get a lot of these guys. Like, we're at 10 right now, and this is only like the second day I've seen them now. So we can use those to get into the mines and do all sorts of good stuff there. We should probably check on the community center as well and just see how we're doing as far as our bundles and stuff goes. Let's see, so it's the 16th. Let's see, what's coming up? No, help wanted. Pam's birthday, really don't care about Pam. Flower dance is on the 24th. I'm not gonna have a date yet, so that's fine. Oh, we got a cutscene. What's this? Welcome to Pierre's, how can I help you? Oh, you know what? I think that's the Joja Mart guy. Yeah, Morris. Ahem. Is he just gonna be like a total... Come and get it, folks. Coupons for 50% off your purchase at Joja Mart. That's very bad form. That's like coming into somebody's comment section and advertising your own channel. He's like walking into the general store and being like, hey guys, come to my store instead. That's very rude. Just going further to prove that Joja Mart is bad, but I can't match those prices, I'd be selling at a loss. Well, I'm sorry, Pierre. And now he's gonna come and rub it in, isn't he? It must be so difficult for you to lose your loyal customers like that. This guy needs to be, like, punched in the face. Can you blame them? Joja Corporation is clearly the superior choice. Soon the whole town will realize that. He's a very bad dude. I do not like him. I do not like him at all. Pierre, my friend. Hopefully you don't go out of business. That would make me very sad. Let's see. What can I sell you? I can sell you 2 daffodils and a parsnip. Sorry, man. That's all I got for you right now. That's it. That's all I got. Yeah. So, a couple things we want to do. Let's head down. Oh, hello, berries. I see you. There we go. Let's head down to the beach as well. We did unlock the bridge. I think it was a couple episodes ago. I'm not entirely sure, but I want to come down here and see if we can pick up any goodies to sell. Yeah, there we go. We got some coral. That stuff sells for a pretty good price. And this is why the bridge is worth doing. It's 300 gold, but you can repeatedly farm or forage this area for resources, and the coral is pretty good. Like, it sells for, I think, 100 gold a pop or something like that. So That's not too bad. And over time, over the course of the game, that's definitely going to add up and get us a pretty good amount of extra cash. So I will certainly take that. Let's sell the clam and 80 a pop. Still, we're getting up there in cash. We're getting up there in money. That's good. Okay, so I think we're good. I want to head into the mines and see if I can get down to level 40. I'm relatively close, and good things, or not level 40, level 20, I should say. I want to see if I can get down to level 20, because I think, if I remember correctly, we actually unlock a new sword if we get down that far, so we're going to give that a go and see if we can make it happen. Can I get up there this way? Yeah, kind of. That's kind of the roundabout way. But anyway, guys, I'm gonna head to the mines, and I'll meet you there in just a little bit. All right, guys, I am back. So, we're here at the mines, and look at this. I'm already up to 19 of these salmon berries. They're all over the place right now. Let's quick head in. Oh, they're not open yet. They don't open up for a couple hours. So, maybe we'll try and make it out of the mines by the time they open so we can head in there. That's the Adventurer's Guild. But for now, let's go down to level 15, which is the lowest level we've been to, and let's kind of dig around and see if maybe we can find, the staircase early. I just want to get down to level 20. I'm not really worried about gathering the resources right now. I'm a lot more worried about just getting down to that level that we need to be at. Now, this area doesn't seem all that amazingly big, so maybe we'll find it quickly, I'm hoping. Staircase, where you be? Anywhere? No? Maybe? Yes? Pretty please? I just need the staircase. It seems like finding the staircase is really the part. Oh, hello, we got a geode. And there's the staircase right there. It seems like finding the staircase is kind of the time-consuming part of exploring the mines. Most of the stuff can just be skipped altogether. I will grab as many of these as I can, though. And the copper, yeah, we should probably grab any easy copper that we can find. It's not like I'm going to run out of energy because since I have all of these salmon berries I can eat. But what I'm really looking for, as I said, is just the way down. That's all I really care about finding right now. Let's see. Now, on the other hand, it would also be very nice to find some torches. Oh, that's one of those bees. I heard it. I hear it. Oh, there it is. Bees. Now, I don't know if we actually, you know what? These things, these are basically bugs. They're bees, and they're actually pretty nasty. The last episode, the one that got deleted that I decided to re-record, was actually called Bugs, and it was all about these guys. There are larvae that kind of hatch in the mines. And they start out as larvae, but once enough time passes, they turn into those bees. And those guys are nasty. Here we go. Here's one of these larvae I was talking about. If I take too long to kill this guy, he's gonna harden and turn into he's gonna turn into one of those bees right there. And then he becomes really annoying. Oh, and now there's a bunch. Okay. All right. We'll just try and hold him back. Stay back. Back. Back, you fiends. Yes. No. Maybe. One down. There we go. Got him. Whew. Those guys are nasty. And there's a whole bunch of those larvae right there. If I can corner them, I might be able to kill them. That one's turning into a bee. These two are turning into bees, and there's, like, nothing you can really do about it. Other than just continually... just keep basically whacking them with the sword until they're all dead. We got him? There we go. Whew. All right. I think we're good. Okay, we're at level 17. We need to go down 3 more levels to unlock the sword. And check that out. There's a ladder right there. So we will for sure get down to level 20. But I'd like to kind of swing around and check out this middle area if I can. Because I have a feeling, yeah, look at all those barrels. There's all sorts of good stuff in there that we can take advantage of. Hopefully we'll be able to find some good stuff. What is this thing? Is this an amethyst? topaz. I'll take it. We should probably eat some more berries as well. Restore some of our energy. There we go. And one more ought to do it. Because I don't have to go down too far. As I said, level 20 is where we get the reward. So, and that's the very next level. And then we'll also unlock the elevator as well. So we can always come back down to level 20. Let's break that. We just gotta kind of break our way through. Now, one thing you can do to break these, the best way to break them is just using a sword. Because swinging your sword does not actually use any energy, which is definitely a useful thing when you're down here trying to survive. I saw Z's. Am I that tired? No. Oh, okay. It's because it's midnight. Oh, man, it's midnight. We're gonna have to hurry back. We're gonna have to speed up. Okay, that's fine. You know what? We'll be okay. We'll be okay. Kill the slime. Thank you. Yep. Break all the boxes. Break all the boxes. What do I not need? Mixed seeds can go away. No, like, go away. Seriously. We'll get that. We've got sap. We've got, some sort of ring there. Cave carrots? What do I not need? Fiber. Fiber can go. Sap can go. Small magnet ring. I will equip that guy. And that's something good. An amethyst. Awesome. A couple of geodes. More copper. Ooh, and hardwood, which is a relatively rare resource, actually. I'll get rid of the slime. There we go. All right, so that's all the good stuff. Now we need to hurry back to that ladder. I don't think I'm going to make it home in time. It's going to be close. I'll make it to the lower story in time. I'll make it to level 20, but I doubt I'm going to be able to make it home by 2 a.m., which is when you have to get home in order to not pass out. And I don't think I'm going to be able to get there that quickly. It's going to be close, but I would be pretty surprised if I can make it home. All right, so let's quick. Let's pause. Let's see. What do I want to do away with? The daffodil. I don't need the daffodil. And that gives us the steel small sword, which does pretty good damage and swings a lot faster. So let's get back to level 0 and try really hard to make it home. I highly doubt that I'm going to make it, though. I really don't think it's going to happen. It'll be close, but no. No way. There is no way that I'm going to make it back before it hits 2 a.m. And there I go. Good night, me. I just passed out. Just fell asleep. Level up. Level 2 combat, plus 5 health points, and now I can craft life elixir. I can now make a staircase, and I get better pickaxe proficiency as well. So that's pretty useful. And I woke up, my gold went down, simply because, like, I passed out in the middle of the village. Like, that's not a good thing. Okay, let's put some of this junk away, just for now. Are these available as well? Yes, they are. Okay, cool. So this is all paused. Let's take our minerals with us. We also got this prehistoric rib. I found that by digging up some worms on the way to the cave, which is pretty cool. Geodes I should take with me to have them broken. And I think that's really all I need for now. I think I'm going to sell this rusty sword at the shop. Let's actually check the fortune teller. How lucky are we? Spirits whispering something. Feel neutral. Day is in my hands. Okay, cool. Forecast for tomorrow, it's going to be clear and sunny all day. Alright, cool. So, wow, look at all this. We have a lot of crops. That is fantastic. I will take all of you. Thank you. Yes, come to me. I love you all. Sweet. And that also significantly reduces the amount of time that I have to spend watering my crops, because a bunch of them are now watered. I've kind of decided, and I think I've talked about this in previous episodes, I've kind of decided that I'm going to switch to, rather than planting a ton of relatively inexpensive crops, I'm going to basically switch to producing a lot of more expensive crops, or I should say less more expensive crops. So basically, I'll have to spend less time watering each day. I think that's probably the best decision. Mr. Welsknight, last night a Joja team member found you incapacitated. 280 gold? What? What a ripoff. That's an insane amount of gold. Wow. I thought it was just going to be 50. 280 gold just to bring me home? Wow. Joja Mart, you're on my list. You are on my list. This means war. I will do, but I'll do something, and you won't like it. Anyway, let's check the community center here and just see if I actually need any of these foraging things. I don't think I will. I'm pretty sure I already turned in that quest. But I'm going to check the I'll check the community center just to make sure before I sell all this stuff, and I should be able to recoup pretty much all of that money, if not, you know, then, and I think probably more than that as well. I've got so much stuff here as far as random crops goes. I should be good. Let's see. So we've got the foraging bundles down there. These should be the crops bundles. So parsnips. I need to wait on my cauliflower, potatoes, green beans. Okay. So this should all be fine. Foraging bundle I've already completed, right? Yes, I have. And that's all going to be winter foraging stuff. We should be able to complete that in a year, I'm hoping, once we've gone through all the seasons. So I think we're good. All right, let's head to the general store and see about selling some of this stuff. Oh, closed on Wednesdays. Okay, well, that's fine. And then we've got a quest here of some sort. What's this? No, stop. Click on the thing. No, not the calendar. There we go. Could someone bring me a catfish? I don't actually know where to get catfish, Gus, so unfortunately I'm gonna have to pass. Sorry about that, buddy. My bad. We will head to the museum, though, and see if we can maybe unlock a new museum reward. That would be pretty cool. Because we've got a bunch of stuff to donate, so maybe we'll get lucky. Maybe we'll get lucky. Let's see here. So we'll go in and donate some stuff to the museum. Let's see. What can I donate? I can donate a topaz. I can donate an amethyst, and I can donate a prehistoric rib bone. So those are all things that I can donate. Doesn't look like I unlocked any new rewards, though, which is kind of disappointing, but that's all right, whatever. Let's also go into the blacksmith, and we're going to break some of this stuff. Let's see. Process the geodes first. We've got 4. Ooh, that's new. We got coal. We got something else shiny. I don't know what that is. Granite. Okay. And then some copper. Okay. What was this? Jamborite and granite. Those can both be donated to the museum as well. That's pretty awesome. We'll sell our quartz. We'll sell our amethyst and our earth crystals. And then I'll donate those two to the museum. And that should get us a decent amount. And then when I sell all those crops, all of this stuff, we should be able to get a pretty significant amount there as well. Hello, I have more stuff to donate. I just came back from geodes. I will put that there and that there. There we go. Excellent. What did we get? We got a reward. What? Oh, sorry. Sorry, guy. Collect rewards. 9 melon seeds. Plant them in the summer. Okay, awesome. That'll be a nice crop. That's a decent, that's not bad. That should give us some free cash. And free cash is the best kind of cash, if you ask me. So, I think we're good. And I think I'd basically like to spend the rest of my day just kind of clearing out some space on the farm, chopping down some trees, and stuff like that. So, I'm gonna head home, guys. I'm gonna do some work in the fields, and I'll come back to you in just a little bit. All right, guys, I am back. I did some work on the farm, and I was just thinking, we should probably run to, I think it's Marnie's, the carpenter, up here. We should probably run over there and see if maybe, just maybe, we can get our hands on, Actually, you know what? Let's check our map real quick. Let's see. Yeah, carpenter shop, right here. We should run to the carpenter shop and see if maybe we can commission a silo to be built. Because then, as we're clearing some stuff out, we'll get hay. Whereas, if you don't have the silo, you clear out that long, tall grass, and you don't get anything for it. So, let's quick run and talk to her. Construct farm buildings. Here we go. We want a silo. Ooh, we need 5 copper bars and 10 clay. I don't think I've got... I mean, obviously I have the 100 gold and the 100 stone, and I've got the copper bars, but I don't think I have 10 clay. So... we might have to hold off on that. What does the chicken coop cost? 300 wood? Okay. So I'm thinking what we'll do is... I don't think we'll have enough time to get it done today. That's too bad. But clay is not super difficult to find. One way you can get clay is just really simple. Just dig up dirt like this, and as you hoe the ground, sometimes you will find clay, just like, it'll just pop out at you. Let's run home and check and see how much we have. Now, it's too late for me to buy the shop up or buy the actual mill because they close at 5. But at least we know now what we need to get the mill. Let me see. Let me just run home and let's check our chest and see what we've got. Oh, also, one good thing to do is while you're doing this, all that farm work, you know, while you're clearing this stuff out, just throw something into your smelter so you can keep that iron ingot source flowing. There we go. Okay, so I have 8 clay. So I would need 2 more to be able to actually make the silo. Which isn't terrible. I mean, that's pretty doable. I suppose maybe I should see if I can get 2 more clay. We've got some time before it gets late, and I've got salmon berries to restore my, to regenerate my, my energy. So maybe that would be the best course of action. Let me just look around for a while, guys, and I'll come back to you in just a little bit. Alright, guys, I am back. So, I'm out looking for clay, but I'm also doing some foraging and stuff as well. I'm actually finding some pretty good stuff. But this right here, these guys are worms. And if you dig those up, sometimes you'll find treasure or clay. It's actually a really good place to find clay as well. Clay is relatively common from those. That was a lost book, though, so that'll appear in the museum, in the library, and I can go read it anytime. Usually, there are certain, like, helpful hints and tips and things like that. So, keep your eyes out for worms, because you never know when you're going to uncover something really good if you're playing Stardew Valley. So, I'm going to head to the beach, and I think I'm going to dig for the clay at the beach. I don't know. I don't really know why. I have a good feeling about it. I have a good feeling about looking for clay at the beach. So, that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna try it. We're gonna see what happens. I make no guarantees, but, we'll see. And we can hoe this stuff up. And one nice thing about the beach is that it's very high in color contrast as well, so we can see, you know, where we can see any worms that might be hanging out, et cetera, et cetera. So let's just kind of dig, like, over in here. I mean, I haven't found any clay yet, but I just need a little bit. I need 2 pieces of clay. That's it. That's all I need, game. Just 2. Please. Pretty please. Maybe you can't find clay at the beach. That would make me very sad. Oh, my energy is dropping like a rock. Let's eat a few of these salmon berries that don't sell for anything. Oh, I see more worms right over there. Totally didn't see them a minute ago. All right. Hello, worms. Something good. Another book. Okay, well, I guess it's better than nothing. It's not the clay. It's not clay, though. I was hoping for clay. I'm feeling lucky about that spot. No, this spot. No, This one. Please, just a little clay. That's all I want. Is that too much to ask? I don't think it is. Anywhere? No? Worms. More worms. What do you have? A trilobite. That's a good museum artifact, I think. Any more worms over here? No? No, not so much. I wonder if clay has, like, some sort of thing where, like, if you dig on this, on these little rocks, you're more likely to find it or something like that. I don't know. Oh, we're gonna have a cutscene. What's this? Is that Linus? Is that his name? The hermit guy? The guy who lives outside of town and sleeps in a tent? Oh, and the grumpy old man. He's angry. Grr, sounds like those raccoons are back again. Filthy varmints. Hi. Hello, I'm just going for a late night stroll. Ah, you turned up at the right moment, son. Could you do an old man a favor? Could you go around the corner and scare off those raccoons for me? They've been causing a real mess. Thanks. Make sure you give them a good scare so they never come back. Okay, I'll go scare the raccoons. I'm totally a wildlife pest control remover guy. Linus! Hi. You're not a raccoon. I would just like to point that out. You're a bit large. You are certainly hairy, but you're a little large for a raccoon. I find lots of hot, fresh food in these cans, stuff that will go to waste if I don't take it. Okay. Do you think there's something wrong with what I'm doing? No, I think it's a shame for food to go to waste. Thanks, Welsknight. I knew you were an open-minded person. I feel good about what I'm doing. I'm not harming anyone. Well, that's true, Linus. That is true indeed. You're just digging through people's trash, which is admittedly not harming anyone, but it's probably not very sanitary, and it probably breaks some food health code stuff written somewhere. You can go on home. I promise I won't rummage in George's can anymore. You can tell him you scared off the raccoons for good. Okay, cool. I'm gonna go home then. Have a good night, Linus. I'll talk to you later. Goodbye. No, you're gonna go rummage through the Stardrop Saloon's cans instead. And then run away. Wait. Gus knows what's going on, I bet. I know what you were doing, Linus. If you need food, just ask. I don't want anyone in Pelican Town to go hungry. Aw, that's nice of you, Gus. You're such a gentleman. Here, I've got a basket of zucchini fritters for you. Just make sure you dip them in my spicy marinara. Go on, take it. I kind of want some zucchini fritters. If I rummage through your trash, will I get some zucchini fritters? Maybe? I really like zucchini fritters. Any? Yes? No? No? No zucchini fritters for me? Ooh, hello! Hello, Abigail. Sorry in advance if I say anything rude. I didn't get much sleep last night. What do you want? Nothing. It's 10:40. I really just want to go to bed. I think that's probably the best thing to do. Yeah, it's late. I'm getting sleepy. I don't want to pass out again and be billed 285 gold or whatever it was that Joja Mart ripped me off for. That was an insane amount, by the way. Completely ridiculous. I will take my copper bar, though. And I did get some stuff that I can sell before I go to bed. So we'll sell the leeks, we'll sell the horseradish, and the oyster. And the other oyster. This thing will donate to the museum. But guys, I think that is going to do it for this episode. So, if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, subscribe, and leave me a comment. I do appreciate it, and it really helps out my channel. You can also find me on Facebook, Twitter, and Twitch. There are links in the video description below, so check that out as well. Otherwise, guys, thanks for watching, and I'll definitely see you next time.